Welcome, everyone, and call the council executive session to order. We have a need to go executive session to, one, discuss and receive legal advice regarding economic development incentives for Project Bruder, Project Kingdom, and Project Phoenix, and to discuss personnel and compensation issues in the offices of elected officials. Do I have a motion?
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Have a motion and a second. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We're in executive session. Mr. Williams, will you please report us out of executive session?
Council went to executive session for the reasons stated in the motion. No action was taken.
Thank you. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We're adjourned.
I'd like to call the Committee on Finance meeting to order and ask Ms. Hannah Moldenhauer to provide the invocation for us and for committee member Dan Owens to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
Please bow your heads with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. We thank you also for this holiday season and the many reasons to celebrate. Let us not forget those many blessings. Lord, we ask that you give our county council guidance this evening. In your name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, has this meeting been properly noticed via the Freedom of Information Act?
Yes, sir, it has.
Thank you very much. First on the agenda is the approval of minutes from the regular committee meeting held on October the 26th.
Move for approval.
Second.
2020. I have a motion by Mr. Newell, a second by Mr. Cheryl Knight. Any corrections or additions to these minutes? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. The minutes stand approved as presented. First reading, next is first reading in committee, Bill Number 2052, an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu between Advanced Technology International and Berkeley County. What's the pleasure of the committee?
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Cheryl Knight, a second by Mr. Newell. Is there any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say nay. That passes first readings. Next is Bill Number 2067, a 16th supplemental
Move for approval.
Ordinance.
Second.
For the borrowing of an amount not exceeding $26 million. Related to a combined utility system in Berkeley County. I have a motion by Mr. Newell, second by Mr. Pinckney. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. That passes unanimously in committee. Next is Bill Number 2070, a fee in lieu, an amendment to a fee agreement by and among Berkeley County.
Move for approval.
Second.
And ARBP Spring Grove LLC. I have a motion by Mr. Newell, a second by Mr. Cox. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. That motion carries unanimously in committee. Next is Bill Number 2071.
Move to approve.
Second.
Philo with A&R Logistics, Inc. I have a motion by Mr. Cox, a second by Mr. Newell. Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. That passes unanimously in committee. Next, we have second reading in committee. Bill Number 2053.
Move for approval.
Second.
For fee in lieu tax incentive agreement for Maguru Enterprises LLC. Motion by Mr. Newell, second by Mr. Cox. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. That motion carries unanimously. Next, we have a consideration of a resolution. Is there anyone from Nexton Development or Nexton Improvement District to present on this issue? Without objection, I'd ask that this be held to the next meeting for me, the chairman, to get more information. And with that, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned.
At this time, I'd like to call the public hearings to order. Madam Clerk, has the meeting been properly noticed via the Freedom of Information Act?
Yes, sir, it has.
Thank you. First up is Bill Number 20-48, an ordinance to modify the official zoning and development standards maps of Berkeley County, South Carolina, in regard to Dwayne Nowicki for a plus or minus 1 acre portion of TMS number 210-00-00-057, located on Godfrey Lane near Highway 17A in the vicinity of Munt's Corner, from Mobile Home Park R3 District to Manufactured Residential R2 District in Council District 6. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-48? Hearing none, that will conclude that public hearing. Next up is bill number 20-49, an ordinance to modify the official zoning and development standards maps of Berkeley County, South Carolina, in regard to Dean Hensley on behalf of Hensley and Lodge Properties, LLC, for TMS number 242-00-02-042, plus or minus 1.03 acres, located on Highway 78 in the Ladson community, from Single Family Residential District to General Commercial District in Council District 4. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-49? Hearing none, that'll conclude that public hearing. Next up is bill number 20-50, an ordinance to modify the official zoning and development standards maps in Berkeley County, South Carolina, in regard to David and Barbara Rogers for a plus or minus 1.57 acre portion of TMS number 123-00-03-098, located on North Highway 52 and Callie's Lane in the vicinity of Santee Circle, from General Commercial GC District to Agricultural Flex 1 District in Council District 8. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-50? Hearing none, that will conclude that public hearing. Next up is bill number 20-51, an ordinance to modify the official zoning and development standards maps of Berkeley County, South Carolina, in regard to David and Barbara Rogers for a plus or minus 0.33 acre portion of TMS number 123-00-03-045, located on North Highway 52 and Callie's Lane in the vicinity of Santee Circle, from Agricultural Flex 1 District to General Commercial District in Council District 8. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-51? Hearing none, that will conclude that public hearing. Next up is bill number 20-52, an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu of tax agreement by and between a company known for the time being as Advanced Technology International, the company, and Berkeley County, whereby Berkeley County will enter into a fee in lieu of tax agreement with the company and providing for payment by the company of certain fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes, providing for the location of the company's property in a multi-county industrial business park and other matters relating thereto. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-52? Hearing none, that will conclude that public hearing. Next up is bill number 20-53, an ordinance authorizing, one, the execution and delivery of a second amendment to an existing fee in lieu of tax incentive agreement by and between Berkeley County, South Carolina, the county, and Maguro Enterprises, LLC, a company previously identified as Project Eagle, and B, a first amendment to an additional existing fee in lieu of tax and incentive by and between the county and the company to effect certain modifications thereto, each with respect to certain property now or to be hereafter located in the county, and two, other matters relating thereto. Would anyone like to speak on bill number 20-53? Hearing none, I conclude that public hearing. I'll adjourn the public hearings and be back in a moment with the regular county council meeting. I'd like to call the regular county council meeting to order. Madam Clerk, has the meeting been properly noticed via the Freedom of Information Act?
Yes, sir, it has.
Thank you. First on the agenda is approval of the minutes from the executive session and special council meetings held on October 12th and the executive session public hearings and regular council meeting held on October 26th, 2020. Have a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Are there any corrections to these minutes? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The minutes stand approved as presented. We have no one signed up for public discussion, so we'll move on to
Living Right. I said we're living right.
Yep. Next on the agenda is review state of emergency resolution R20-03. Do I have a motion to extend the state of emergency resolution until the next regular council meeting?
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. All in favor, please say aye.
Mr. Chairman, can we have discussion?
Yeah, any discussion?
Of course, I trust you completely, but is there still a reimbursement reason we need an emergency resolution?
Absolutely, and with the way numbers have been trending more adversely than favorable, it would be wise to keep this resolution in place.
Mr. Chairman, I understand the numbers are trending, and I do follow them every day, but we now have 9 months to plan for worst-case scenarios, so I just think it's a practice. We should now be prepared with all the PPP we need and all the whatever, whatever, for worst-case scenarios. And short of an expectation of the CARES Act or something that we need to be in a state of emergency, I don't think we're in an emergency. I think your leadership, we are well prepared to handle what comes. So have we confirmed that it is a requirement to be in a state of emergency?
I believe Ben Almquist did some research into this, and he had a memo prepared at one point that indicated that the potential risk to compromising FEMA reimbursement was not worth it. It wasn't clear whether that was necessary or not, and so it was more beneficial to leave the state of emergency in place because we didn't want to compromise those funds.
Is CARES Act even FEMA money?
I don't know if the CARES Act is the sole source of I guess, funding reimbursement.
Have we done anything related to trigger FEMA reimbursements?
I'm unaware. I don't know.
Well, I think we should lead this state in saying we're not in an emergency. We're prepared for whatever comes by way of numbers. And short of a financial reason to do it, you know, I guess what I'll say is I'll go one more month with this, but next month I'm going to have even more difficult questions.
Thank you, Mr. Whitney.
Mr. Chairman.
We'll drill down on that, definitely. But it's an ongoing pandemic and an ongoing issue, and typically things come and go in 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 days. And by the time we meet again, we're getting rid of whatever we enacted. This just continues to be ongoing, but we'll ask some pressing questions.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Cox.
I'd like to echo Mr. Whitley's concerns, not about you, but what emergency are we in? And we've asked this question before, and you're doing a great job, don't get me wrong. But an emergency doesn't seem to be the right word of where we currently are. I don't know that we're in an emergency, and you guys have done great to prepare us for an emergency, but I'm with Councilman Whitley on this.
Any other discussion?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Payne.
You know, we had an incident that happened here within in the building as far as closing down a department. And when we talk about, you know, making sure that we're prepared going forward, are there any specific action that has been taken to prepare or to safeguard from this happening in the future, such as PPEs or what exactly has been done going forward? Because, you know, with the way it's going, and it's always been stated, and I believe in it, that an ounce of prevention is worth more than a pound of cure. And it's, you know, before this happened here in the county office building, I'm just not concerned about employees, but I am too, because employees are our biggest asset that we have. And we need to make sure that they're protected. But going forward, public comes in here. But we need to make sure that our public, our citizens are protected. And if we can show that we have not only put forth a concerted, but we've got specific things in place to make sure that we can hopefully stop the numbers from trending. And it needs to be publicly known, I believe. I know you've got some saying it's a myth and all this, but that's not the case. And as a governing body, we need to be more prudent than anybody else, regardless of the politics, regardless of what you believe. But the numbers speak for itself. And so I'm concerned about that. I have been from the beginning, and even more so now, because employees, their family comes into play too. They come out here and they work. then they got to go back home and to wife, children, grandchildren, things of that nature. We need to give them some kind of blessed assurance based on what we do from a governing body standpoint. I just need that to go on record. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Pinkney. Any other discussion? All right, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up, we have reports from standing committees. First up is Committee on Finance, Chairman Josh Whitley, District Number 2.
Mr. Chairman, the Committee on Finance met earlier this evening, and all items on the agenda have been addressed. That concludes my report.
Thank you, Mr. Whitley. Next up is Committee on Land Use, Chairman Tommy Newell, District Number 4.
Mr. Chairman, the Committee on Land Use met on November 9th, 2020. On recommendation of the committee, I move to deny bill number 20-55, which is a request from Davison Floyd on behalf of JW Aluminum to rezone TMS number 234-08-00-027 and 234-08-00-028 and 234-08-00-029 from residential R1 district to light industrial district. Mr. Chairman, that concludes my report.
All right, I have a motion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Nay.
Nay.
That motion carries. That concludes your report. All right, next up is Committee on Auxiliary Services. Chairman Philip Obey II.
Mr. Chair, the Committee on Auxiliary Services met on November 9th, 2020. On recommendation of the committee, I move to approve providing the county supervisor with authority to sign the grant agreement with PetSmart Charities in the amount of $65,000.
I have a motion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries.
Does that conclude your report?
Oh, that concludes my report. Sorry.
Next up is Committee on Community Services, Mr. Steve Davis.
Mr. Chairman, the Committee on Community Services met on November 9, 2020. On recommendation of the committee, I move to approve acceptance of the Lois Linsky Covey Foundation Bookmobile grant funds in the amount of $1,500.
I have a motion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The motion carries.
Also, Mr. Adam Hammonds, Registration and Election Director, provided us with post-election update and no action was taken. Mr. Chairman, that concludes my report.
Thank you, Mr. Newell. Next up is Committee on Justice and Public Safety, Chairman Jack Shurlnight.
Mr. Chairman, the Committee on Justice and Public Safety met on November 9th, 2020. On recommendation of the committee, I move to approve for Mr. Ben Onquist, Emergency Management Director, or his designee to apply for the 2020 Hazardous Mitigation Grant in the estimated amount of $250,000.
I have a motion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries.
Also, Mr. Onquist provided an update on the activities of the Berkeley County COVID-19 Task Force, and no action was taken. Mr. Chairman, that concludes my report.
Thank you, Mr. Shurlnight. Next up is Committee on Administrative Services, Chairman Brandon Cox.
No report, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Cox. Next up is Committee on Operations, Chairman Caldwell Pinkney, Jr.
No report, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Pinkney. And finally, Committee on Public Utilities, Chairman Dan Owens.
No report, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Owens. Moving on to third reading, bill number 20-48, an ordinance to modify the official zoning and development standards maps of Berkeley County, South Carolina, in regard to Dwayne Nowicki for a plus or minus 1 acre portion of TMS number 210-00-00-057, located on Godfrey Lane near Highway 17A in the vicinity of Munt's Corner, from the Mobile Home Park R3 district to the Manufactured Residential District in Council District 6. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
A motion and second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is bill number 20-49.
Move for approval.
Second.
A motion and second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-50.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-51.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-53, an ordinance authorizing
the... Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is second reading. Bill Number 20-52, an ordinance authorizing...
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-54, an ordinance...
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-56.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-57.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-58.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-59.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-60.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-61.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-62.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-64.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-65, an ordinance to amend...
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-66.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-67.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-70.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Next up is Bill Number 20-71.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Moving on to first reading, bills for first reading are not discussed or voted upon. The bills are read into the record by title only and thereafter sent to proper committee for further consideration. First item is Bill Number 20-73, an ordinance authorizing an amendment to the agreement governing the joint multi-county industrial park by and between Williamsburg County, South Carolina and Berkeley County, South Carolina, to authorize the expansion of the boundaries of the park and other matters relating thereto. Next item is Bill Number 20-74, an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu of tax agreement by and among a company known for the time being as Project Kingdom, a company known for the time being as Project Kingdom Developer, and Berkeley County, South Carolina, whereby Berkeley County will enter into a fee in lieu of tax agreement providing for payment of certain fees in lieu of ad valorem taxes and other matters. Next up is Bill Number 20-75, an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu of tax agreement by and between Berkeley County, South Carolina and Project Bruder with respect to certain economic development property in the county, providing for payment by Project Bruder of certain fees in lieu of ad valorem taxes and matters relating thereto. Next up, we have a resolution. Item one is resolution of the County Council of Berkeley County, South Carolina. All right, that item has been held. Thank you, Mr. Whitley. Next up is nominations for membership on boards and commissions. Do we have any nominations this evening? Madam Clerk, is all of our committees full right now?
There's a vacancy on the library board.
Okay, thank you. That's a recent vacancy, correct? Thank you. Next up is chairman's time. I don't have anything to add. And finally, I have an announcement. The December regular meeting of County Council will be held on Monday, December 14, 2020, immediately following public hearings, and any scheduled committee meeting at 6 p.m. in the Assembly Room of Berkeley County Administration Building, 1003 Highway 52, Munts Corner, South Carolina. This time, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned.
That was probably the shortest meeting.